It's round 3 of LeBron James versus Brad Stevens in the playoffs. The Celtics coach is widely regarded as one of the best in the NBA, and he will try to squeeze every bit of basketball from this depleted roster to try and avoid an 0-3 record against the King. This is the blueprint in my opinion. Boston will try throwing different defenders on LeBron. They have a few guys that can hold their own against him. Jaylen Brown will probably get most of the responsibility, but Tatum and Morris will also try to slow down James. I anticipate these guys to be a tougher matchup than OG Anunoby and Pascal Siakam, who were the primary defenders for Toronto and couldn't get a stop to save their lives. I believe that because of the combination of size and length that the Celtics have, it's gonna be tougher for LeBron to make all those fadeaway shots from the Raptors series. Even when he starts making shots, I expect double teaming with quick recovery, which I'm sure that this team is capable of doing. However, the one thing Brad Stevens knows is that he cannot leave Kyle Korver or J.R. Smith for a wide open three. They were absolutely shooting lights out in the previous round, combining for 63%. The Celtics proved that they can rotate and contest the three well against the Sixers, where they were able to help on Simmons or Embiid and guard the three-point line at the same time. I love how Smart, Rozier, and even Larkin were able to recover and get out to the shooter and contest. Philadelphia shot only 30.8% from downtown. Of course, besides their similarities, it's definitely a lot different guarding Simmons and guarding LeBron. Boston was able to put Al Horford as a primary defender on the rookie and get away with it. Against the Cavs, he would only help out by closing the lane on James's drives and hope that his teammates are helping the helper or that the Cleveland shooters are having an off night. Actually, Horford's matchup against Love is probably going to be the second most interesting in these games. After the physical battle against Toronto and Valanciunas, Love now meets someone who is very similar to him, a stretch 4 converted to center to accommodate the needs of the team. If Horford can substantially outplay Love, Boston has a legitimate chance of winning the series. It all depends how much of the offensive load can he carry, and how much guys like Tatum, Brown and Rozier will be able to contribute. Scary Terry has been the revelation for the Celtics these playoffs, and his coach will look for him to be the anchor of the perimeter defense and to provide some fast break and transition points. Those 18 points per game throughout the postseason from him, as well as the 19 from Tatum, will be crucial for the team. Brad Stevens is counting on the extremely disciplined and resilient team to execute the game plan and fight to the last bit of energy against a clearly more talented opponent. The Cavs might end up winning the series, but they will definitely have to earn that victory. That's it for now. Like this video if you liked it and subscribe if you haven't. Talk to you in the next one. Peace out.